Subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to stay updated with the latest news and tech videos.
Hello everyone and welcome to our Tech Talker style speed test comparison between the P30 and P30 Pro. And without waiting, we'll start off with the power test in 3, 2, 1. So both of the logos came at the same time. In my opinion, there won't be any much difference because both of them are supporting EMU 9.1 and Kirin 987 nanometer processor. And as you saw, both of these phones loaded at the same time. So we'll start off with the in-display fingerprint test in 3, 2, 1. And as you saw, about the same. We'll do that with the screen turns on this time. Not much of a difference. In fact, it was about the same at both of the times. So we'll start off with the basics phone dialer. Same. Messaging. Same. Google Chrome. Same. We'll open Play Store. And again, the same. And now we'll go to some third-party apps. We'll start off with Facebook first. Same loading time on both of these phones. Both of them loaded the same feed as well. We'll open a news application, don.com. Faster on the Pro model. We'll open Instagram this time. And as you saw, about the same feeds, same video showing at the same time. We'll open my profile. A bit faster on the Pro model over here. And we'll open Quick and GIF. So, mild faster on the Pro model. Now moving on to some gaming application. We'll open Surface Surfers. So the Pro model wins it over here. Pinout. A bit faster maybe on the normal version. I will need to see that again. As for line, some heavy duty gaming application. And the loading time is about the same. Seems this would be a fair competition as well. Oh, so I did this second time. I recorded it, I deleted that part, I recorded it again, and even the second time the normal version loaded a bit faster. I'm not sure why. So overall the phones have been performing really well. It's an even competition. And now opening the camera, look, even the camera app opens at the same time. So other than the screen size and the camera on the back, nothing is different between these both phones. Both have the same RAM. A battery is better on the Pro model, of course, but with the 8GB RAM on both models, storage options being the same, the processor Kirin 980, the 7 nanometer chipset being the same as well on both of these phones, make these phones equally competitive. Both of them have the options of the in-display fingerprint reader, and both have a really good RAM management. I won't be testing that over here because I know it's really good. It will be equal the same way the application opening time was equal on both of these phones. So if you are undecided and if you do not want to spend so much on the Pro model, there's always an option of the lighter version, the basic P30, in which you're also getting the headphone jack. In my opinion, I will be getting this as a second device alongside either the S10 Plus or the P30 Pro. I have not decided on that. I will be doing a comparison of the P30 Pro and the S10 Plus, and I will be comparing this phone against the S10 Plus as well as both of these phones against the Note 9. And it will be clear for all of you if you want to shift to Huawei or if you want to continue if you are using a Samsung phone. In my opinion, Huawei has done a lot in the past few years. to gain this market share, to make some really good phones. And what do you think about Huawei phones? Do comment in the comment section below. Also, make sure you are subscribed, because it helps a lot if you are subscribed to the channel if you are watching this video. And till the next video, take care. Bye bye.